this talk, I explain vanishing theorem. And in the next talk, I will explain some applications of vanishing theorems in the log minimal model program. Everything is defined over C in this talk. Okay. First, let us recall some vanishing theorem. Okay. First theorem is known as Kawamata-Feebeck vanishing theorem. Vanishing theorem. Okay, so let X be a smooth projective variety. Smooth projective variety defined over C, and V is effective Q divisor on X, such that the support of B is a simple normal crossing divisor. And round down of B equals zero. In this case, this means the coefficient of B is less than one. This is a fractional part of this Q divisor. Okay? And L is a net Cartier divisor. Cartier divisor on X. Assume L minus Kx plus B is nef and B. Then the higher cohomology HIX OXL equals zero. So I is positive. Okay? This is known as Kawamata-Feebeck vanishing theorem. And some remarks. So Q divisor on X. So B is nef. This is the definition. Nef means numerically effective or numerically eventually free. D is nef if and only if D dot C is non-negative for any curve C. And nef divisor D is weak if and only if, this is a definition, D self-intersection number of D is positive, n equals dimension X. Okay? And so in particular, D is ample in the usual sense, then D is nef and weak. Okay. So in theorem, this is theorem A. Okay. So in theorem A, if B equals zero and L minus Kx plus B equals, because B is ample. So ample. So we can use theorem A. Then in this case. Theorem A is nothing but Kodaira vanishing theorem. Kodaira's vanishing theorem for algebraic variety. Okay. Okay, let's go to the next theorem. Theorem B. It is known as nasal vanishing soil. Vanishing soil.More precisely, it is an algebraic version, algebraic version of nasal vanishing soil. Okay. Let X be a normal projective variety, normal projective variety, and B.Is the effective Q divisor, effective Q divisor on X such that KX, of course, KX is the canonical divisor of X. Okay, KX plus B, and it is well defined since X is normal. So, as a base divisor, well known as a base divisor. So, KX plus B is.Q cartier. This means there exists a positive integer m such that m times kx plus b is cartier. Okay? And L is a Neff cartier divisor. Cartier divisor on X.Assume L minus KX plus B is Neff and Beek. Same condition as in theorem A. Then HI X OXL tensor multiplied of sieve I XPequal zero for positive I. Okay, so this is a multiplier of C. Multiplier of C. C of this pair XP, and I will explain this ideal C after theorem C. Okay, XP. Okay, next one, theorem C.It is relative Kawamata feedback vanishing theorem. Special case of relative Kawamata feedback vanishing theorem. Okay. X is a normal projective variety. Normal projective variety. And B is an effective Q divisor on X.Such that kx plus b is q cartier. Same as in theorem b. And if y to x is a projective resolution, this means y is a smooth projective variety and f is birational.And such that ky plus by equal f pullback kx plus b. More precisely, by is defined by this formula. We can pull back this divisor since this is Q cartier and the canonical divisor of y is well defined. So by this formula, we define by. And we can assume support by is a simple normal crossing divisor by Hironaka's resolution divisor. So this situation is reasonable, simple normal crossing divisor. Then, in this situation, higher direct image, ry f push forward oy minus round down.by equals zero for any I, a positive I. Okay? It is a special case of relative Kawamata feedback vanishing theorem. the I add some definition. In this notation, IXB multiplied by C can be written F push forward O Y minus round down of B Y. This is multiplied by C of this pair XP. Okay?I explain some remark. In theorem B, if X is smooth and support B is simple normal crossing and round down of B equals zero, then we can easily see this ideal C multiplied by C is trivial. So theorem B is a generalization of theorem A. Sorry. Yeah, you are right. A Calpi divisor. Okay. Sorry. Calpi divisor. Okay. So theorem B is a generalization of theorem A. Oh, is it okay? And theorem C.Relative version. We can prove theorem B, C by using theorem A, global result. This part is routine work by Rudeis spectral sequence. Rudeis spectral sequence and Sayles theorem. Sayles theorems A and B.It is a routine work. So, and theorem B can be proved by using theorem A plus theorem B, theorem C. This part is also easy by using Hironaka's resolution and Rudeis spectral sequence.So first take resolution and apply theorem A and by using relative vanishing theorem C, we obtain theorem B. Since multiply ideal C can be written like this. Okay? So as I explained now,Kawamata-Feedback vanishing theorem is a generalization of Kodaira's vanishing theorem. This is theorem A. And Nadel's vanishing theorem, theorem B, is also a generalization of Kodaira's vanishing theorem. And in our setting, these theorems.Essentially the same in algebraic situation. Okay? Originally, Nadel vanishing theorem is an analytic result. Okay? In our situation, these theorems are essentially the same. And Grauert-Riemann-Schneider vanishing theorem.It's also a generalization of Kodaira's vanishing theorem, and relative Kawamata feedback, this is theorem C, is a kind of generalization of Grauert-Riemann-Schneider vanishing theorem. And there exists one more important generalization, Corral's Corral's theorem. Injectivity, torsion free, and vanishing theorem. Vanishing theorem. Okay. And next I explain generalized Corral's theorem. Corral's theorem. This is theorem D. And theorem D, generalized Corral's theorem, easily implies everything. So theorem D implies everything. Relative Kalamata feedback and of course original Corral's theorem. Okay? And it is well known that theorem B, I will explain later. Theorem B, generalized Corral theorem, comes from pure Hodge structure. So the main goal of this talk is generalized. So I would like to explain mixed version of Corral theorem. Corral's theorem. I explain this later, so theorem E. And this comes from mixed Hodge structure. This is the main goal of this talk. Okay? And In the second talk, I will specialize this theorem, and I will obtain various useful results. Then we apply. Then we obtain applications to the log minimal model program. Okay, this part is in second talk. Okay, theorem D. Theorem D. Corral's theorem. Corral's torsion free and vanishing theorem. Okay, let Y be a smooth projective variety, of course defined over C, and delta is the effective Q divisor on Y, and such that support delta is a simple normal crossing, and round down of delta equals zero. It's a usual assumption. And if y to x is a surjective morphism onto a projective variety. X is not necessarily smooth. We only assume X is projective variety. And D is a Cartier divisor. Cartier divisor on Y. The first statement, if D minus KY plus delta is Q linearly equivalent to F pullback N for some Q Cartier Q divisor, Q divisor M on X. This means some multiple of this is linearly equivalent to some multiple of this one. Okay, for some Q Cartier Q divisor M on X, then higher direct image or YD higher direct image of OID is torsion free for any positive I. Okay, in particular, if F is birational, then this F is obviously torsion. So, Ry, F push forward, OYD equals zero for any positive I. Okay? Second theorem, this is a vanishing theorem. If... Yeah, of course, yeah. Generically finite is enough. If D minus KY plus delta is Q linearly equivalent to F pullback M, same situation, and we assume M is an ample Q divisor on X. This means some multiple of M is ample in the usual sense. Then HI X RJ F push forward OYD equals zero for any positive I and any non-negative J. Okay? This is a slight generalization of Collard's original torsion free and vanishing theorems. Yeah, already classical result. So, remark, theorem C, so the relative Kalamata feedback vanishing theorem is a special case of theorem theorem D. D1. Okay. So in my opinion, theorem C is not a relative version of vanishing theorem. It is a special case of torsion free theorem. And the theorem is a special case of theorem A. So theorem B follows from theorem D2. This part is an easy exercise by resolution of singularities and Podaira's lemma. Podaira's lemma means a big divisor can be written ample divisor plus effective divisor. Okay. Okay. Theorem A, B, C, and D are now classical. Classical result. For example, so Professor Eno and Kibet's lecture note. DMV seminar note. Okay. And theorem A, B, and C has many, many applications. But in my opinion, theorem D has not so many applications. But in this talk, I explain a generalization of theorem D, and in the next talk, I will explain applications of theorem E. Theorem E is a generalization of theorem D. Okay. So I finish a quick review of classical vanishing theorem. Okay. So let's go to the next section. Before I explain theorem E. So theorem E means a mixed version of this theorem. I need some notation and definitions. So in this section, we introduce some definitions of singularities of pairs. So in this section, X is a normal variety. Here, X is not necessarily projective. X is a normal algebraic variety, and B is an effective Q divisor on X, such that Kx plus B is Q Cartier, as usual. Okay, and let F Y to X is a good resolution. A good resolution means F is projective variational morphism and Y is smooth, and every divisor on Y we want to consider has a simple normal crossing support. So support union exceptional locus of F union F strict transform of B is a simple normal crossing divisor. Yeah. Then we can write KY equal F pullback KX plus B plus summation AIEI. Okay. So E A I I. We write A E I X B is defined as A I, and this is a rational number. In this situation, XB is called KLT. KLT is an abbreviation of Karmatov terminal. This is the definition. AI is greater than minus 1 for any I. This is the definition of Karmatov terminal pair, KLT. And XB is log canonical if and only AI is greater than or equal to minus 1 for any I. So, of course, KLT pair is log canonical by definition. And I need very important definition. Let XB be a log canonical pair, and C, C is a closed subset of X, is an LC center, log canonical center, it is by definition, it is definition, there exists FY to X, this is a good resolution.And I0 such that AI0 equal minus 1 and C equal the image of FEI0. Okay? So there is some I0 inside this set and AI0 equal minus 1 and C is the image of the divisor whose coefficient is minus 1. Okay, this is the definition of LC center. Sorry? There is some resolution. Okay. So, one more definition. B is a Q divisor. B is called boundary if and only if the coefficient of Bi is between 0 and 1 for any I. Okay, I will use this notation in example, in theorem E. So,X is a smooth variety, and summation Bi is reduced to simple normal crossing divisor on X. So the picture is like this. X is a smooth variety, and Bi is like this. So the pair X summation Bi Bi is KLT if and only if Bi is less than 1 for any I. And this pair is log canonical if and only if Bi is less than or equal to 1 for any I. Okay? And we can write B equals summation Bi Bi is like this. Bi I is between 1 and K. This is a reduced part of this divisor plus summation K plus 1 J L BJ 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 is less than 1 if is KLT. Okay? If this pair is KLT, log canonical, then the question is less than or equal to 1. So we can write by changing the numbering, we can write as follows. This is a reduced part of B. More equivalent, this is round down of B, and this is a fractional part of B. This is B minus round down B. Okay? No. Just a Q divisor. We do not assume the support is simple normal crossing. Yeah. But in this example, support is simple normal crossing. Okay?
Any device can give it very, very small crosses.
Yeah. So in the situation, in that situation, a low canonical center, of pair XB is an irreducible component of BI1 intersection BIM. And I1 dot IM is a subset of 1 dot K. Okay, so picture like this. X and B1, for example, B1, B2. So low canonical center is, so this one and this one and the intersection here. Okay. Okay, let's go to the main theorem of this this talk. Theorem E. Yeah, this theorem looks very artificial, but very powerful. There are too many contributors. So, too many contributors. Corral is the pioneer of this theorem, and Professor Eno and Tibek, and many contributors, and Ambro, he found this formulation, Ambro and many contributors. Okay? Why is the smooth projective variety? And B is a boundary Q divisor. Divisor such that support B is a simple normal crossing divisor. Okay, so the support of B is simple normal crossing. So the boundary means the coefficient of B is between 0 and 1. Okay, and F Y to X is a projective morphism. Morphism onto a projective variety, X. X is not necessarily smooth. And L is a Cartier divisor, on Y, such that H is Q linearly equivalent to L minus KY plus P is F semi-ampo. So some multiple of this divisor is generated by global section relatively. In this situation, first theorem, this is a generalization of Torsion-free theorem. Any non-zero local section, any local section of non-zero local section of this sieve, higher direct image, OYL, contains in its support. The F image of some strata of YB. okay, where astoratum of YB denotes Y itself or an LC center of the pair YB. Okay? So if YB is KLT, then a stratum of YB is nothing but Y. So this theorem says this sieve contains X, so this means torsion freeness if YB is KLT. Okay? If YB is KLT, so there are no LC centers. So stratum of YB is Y. So the image of Y is X projective morphism onto a projectivity X. So any non-zero local section of this sieve contains X in its support. So it means this is torsion free if YB is KLT. Okay? In the second statement, assume H is Q linearly equivalent to pullback of F pullback H for some ampoule Q Cartier Q divisor. Q divisor H prime on X. Okay. This assumption is same as in theorem B2. Then higher direct image higher cohomology like this equals zero for any positive P and any non-negative Q. The same statement as in theorem B2. Okay? The difference is here. Yeah, boundary. So in theorem E, we assume B round down equals zero. So this means summation BI DI. So if B equals summation BI BI, so this means BI is less than one. But in this theorem, BI is BI may be one. Okay, small difference. I explain idea of the proof of the proof. Okay. V is a smooth projective variety. Projective variety defined over C, and we know what to the Drum spectral sequence H1 PQ So this is the HQ X omega XP to HP plus Q. The cohomology group, singular cohomology group with coefficients C degenerates at E1. Okay. Theorem D. Theorem D follows from this E1 degeneration. Okay. It is very well known, and so for example, Korar's book, Shafari bitmaps and automatic cohom, or Professor Eno and Feebeck's lecture. Okay. The let sigma be a simple normal crossing divisor on X, on V, and iota is a natural open image on V minus sigma to V. This is a natural open image on. Okay. Then we can easily check that iota shriek C V minus sigma. This is a constant C on a smooth non-projective variety V minus sigma, and the iota shriek is a zero extension of this constant C. This is quasi isomorphic to the following complex O V dot log sigma tensor OV minus sigma. It can be checked locally. So we have positron spectral sequence HIPQ, HQ, X, XV, omega VP log sigma tensor OV minus sigma to HP plus Q CV minus sigma C. This is a compact support cohomology group of V minus sigma. Okay. This spectral sequence is named as star. Okay. Left hand side of the upper side. This term is dual to the cell duality. By using cell duality, H minus N minus Q, N is the dimension of V, H N minus Q, V omega V N minus P log sigma. And this cohomology group is dual to this is Poincaré duality H2N minus P plus Q V minus sigma C. Okay, so this spectral sequence degenerates at E1 by the famous results by Durin on the Durin. This means H1 AB HB V omega V A to log sigma HA plus B V minus sigma C degenerates at E1. Okay? This is a well-known Dorinio's theorem. By using this E1 degeneration, we obtain E1 degeneration of this spectral sequence. Okay? So, and the E1 degeneration, E1 degeneration of asterisk implies theorem D. This part is well known and described in Corral's book and Enotic's lecture note. E1 degeneration of star, I explained it now, implies theorem E. Now, this part essentially the same. The same argument. What? So all you have to do is to replace the input data, E1 degeneration of this sequence, with E1 degeneration of this spectral sequence. Okay? So, I make some remarks. All the ingredients we need were known 20 years ago. So there are no difficulties to prove theorem E once we know the correct formulation of theorem E. Okay. So as I explained before, theorem D is the E1 degeneration of this one. So theorem D comes from pure Hodge structure, and the theorem E comes from mixed Hodge structure. So theorem E is a mixed version of theorem D, I think. And it is well known that the notion of KLT corresponds to pure Hodge structure, and the notion of log and Cartier corresponds to mixed Hodge structure. Okay. So theorem E will play crucial role in the study of Lokan pairs, LC pairs. Okay. In the second talk, I will explain some applications of theorem E So second talk, I explain, I specialize the theorem E. Theorem E is I think the statement of theorem E is very difficult to understand. So I make some useful results by using theorem E. So first, specialize theorem E and apply them to the log minimal model program for log canonical pairs. Okay. Yeah, I stop here.